Hi everyone, this is Pooja Desai and I welcome you all to another fun session with Off the Record with Pooja. And today we have a very, very special guest, that is Her Highness Maharani Radhika Raje Gaikwad. We are going to talk about her soon, but more importantly, let me just give you a, you know, little fun facts. थोड़ा कुछ बता दूँ मैं आपको अपने जो लक्ष्मी विलास पैलेस है जहाँ महारानी और उनकी डॉटर्स और समरजीत जी हैं और उनकी राजमाता जो रहते हैं उनके बारे में मैं थोड़ा बताना चाहती हूँ. लेट मी जस्ट सेट द पेस फॉर द सेशन. सो लेट मी टेल यू, लक्ष्मी विलास पैलेस is almost 4 times bigger than the Buckingham Palace, that is in London. It is the largest private dwelling and it has 170 rooms. सिर्फ दो लोगों के लिए बनाए गए थे but 170 rooms. You can imagine कितना बड़ा ये palace है. इस palace को complete होते होते 12 साल लग गए थे और वहाँ एक clock tower है जो almost 300 feet tall है. इसकी एक खासियत ये है कि जब ये बन रहा था आर्किटेक्ट मेजर चार्ल्स बना रहे थे एंड व्हाट हैपेंड वाज ही हंग हिमसेल्फ. सुसाइड किया उन्होंने बिकॉज जब वो कैलकुलेशंस कर रहे थे उन्होंने रियलाइज किया कि ये इमारत गिर जाएगी. ऐसा कुछ हुआ तो नहीं बिकॉज अभी भी अपना पैलेस इंटैक्ट है. 125 इयर्स ऑलमोस्ट हो गए इनको. सो आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू रिक्वेस्ट राधिका. वी जस्ट वेटिंग फॉर अ कंफर्मेशन एंड राधिका इज गोइंग टू बी first time live with both her daughters, that is Padmaja Raje and Narayan Raje. Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
Fine.
Hi Radhika, thank you. Thank you so much for being here. And I just can't wait. I can't wait to talk to the girls, not you. hi girls. So could you give your introduction in Marathi? Yete Marathi tumhi dhondila? No, okay, but doesn't matter. Just give you an introduction for people who don't know you guys because you guys are first time live. So let's go.
My
anyone?
Name is Padmaja Raje.
Yes. Yes.
My name is Narayani Raje.
Yes. So for all the viewers here, Radhika is live first time with Padmaja Raje and Narayani Raje. So So we are going to have a lot of girls. Are you prepared? We are going to have a lot of fun sessions, and you will also have to do a lot of imitation of your mom, your dad. So mentally start preparing yourself. So a little introduction, okay? Before Radhika we start, I just want to put in a little words to all the viewers who are joining us. राधिका एंड आई गो बैक 15-16 ईयर्स बैक जब हम दोनों की शादी साथ में हुई थी 2002 में एंड वी बोथ गॉट टू नो ईच अदर बिकॉज हम दोनों ने गोल्फ शुरू किया था साथ में एंड यस एंड आई रिमेम्बर राधिका फ्रॉम दोज टाइम्स दैट बबली दैट चोपी लेट्स डू दिस लेट्स डू दैट टाइप एंड शी हैज बीन सो ग्राउंडेड. Very few people you see of that stature who are so grounded, so strong in values, and I think Radhika is one of them, a living example in front of us. So yeah, welcome again Radhika, and I'm going to start bombarding you, though I'm not used to bombarding you so much, but I'm going to start. So tell me Radhika, it's been years. But you know, it has never flashed in my mind, or maybe I never mustered that courage to ask how you and Sam got hooked. आप दोनों का कैसे? Yeah.
It was an arranged marriage. So my sister-in-law Alokika Raje, my husband's sister, she is married to our where I come from, Wakaner. We are old family friends.
Yeah.
So she thought of this alliance. And then, of course, my husband came to, first my mother-in-law and my grandmother-in-law, my nani-sas, they visited us in Delhi. And just, you know, I was 22. So we had a dinner or a tea party. So we had invited them to, and wahan pe thoda casual meet hua. And then, you know, they must have given the feedback or whatever, you know. And then, but then my husband, you know, came and we met. And he was very quiet, you know how he is.
But I know.
We met as a, you know, in a group, and of course, I think I must have been chatting away as always.
I'm sure.
That's how it started. But then, it was, he pursued, he kind of convinced me ki,
yeah, it's going to be a good move for you guys, I said, that you got to be here. So, when you moved initially, it was a very big move for me as well, because I am originally from Bombay. So, there were teeny instances that, usually you are not cutting your words me. So, do you remember any such particular experience, instance, you always read your memory, okay, this is what happened in my initial years, and it will always remain till years to come.
It was just a funny incident, when I got married, and I was, of course, I was a history student, so I would say, that arch looks very nice from here. And my husband says, you are here to stay, you're not here on a tourist visa. Aram se I'm still in that process of discovering new things in the house, So I always find it so funny ki it's true. Most time nahi dekha aur abhi bhi still discovery chali raha hai.
I'm sure. I was just giving a synopsis. I said, ye palace jo itna bada hai, has 170 rooms. I need to ask Radhika ke sabhi rooms dekhe hain, tumne aaj tak ki nahi dekhe.
Actually, the rooms, the size is so varying. It's like a 2x2, the Darbar Hall size. So the rooms are varying sizes. But I think now I've seen.
I'm sure. So, okay. This is the question for the girls. Okay, Narayani and Padmaja for you. So tell me, are there any can't do or any restrictions for you, both of you, vis-a-vis the other kids when you see them outside? Because you're princesses. So aisa kabhi hua hai? Ne bola, Padmaja, no. Narayani, you can't do this. They can do it, but you can't do it. Has it ever happened for both of you?
Yes, it has.
It has? Then can you please tell me what was it?
Like, we have to have proper etiquettes when we're outside. We cannot talk loud.
That's true. That's very nice. I'm sure. Because you other they don't even have to think twice. You can behave like this. But I'm sure you have those certain set of rules that you need to follow, at least when you're in public.
Yes.
And now you're in which grade, Padmaja?
I'm in the 8th.
8th. And Narayani in grade 6, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So, Radhika, I am very curious to know, and I'm sure others are also, that what we hear about the life of royalty, when you think about Jodha, Padmavat, those elephants flashing in your mind and horses and everything. So in real, is the life so much filled with grandeur, or is it very different to what it is portrayed in the movie?
I'll tell you what, it's a very, very normal life. It's a very normal life. Of course, you are living in a beautiful surroundings. So that is your sense of grandeur. And we get flashes of grandeur from time to time when we have our functions. Grandeur in the sense that it's still grand compared to what your day-to-day life is. And it is that age-old traditions that are being carried on for generations. Done with full earnestness and sincerity as it was done that many years back. Of course, maybe the whole scale has come down. But in my view, that sentimentality still makes it as grand, And because the surroundings are so grand, aap Chennai bajaoge to aur grandeur aayega hi, It just feels like somebody comes. We do it in our own way. But it feels very grand to us. So yes, I feel I get those flashes of, what it must have been like 100 years ago. Very, very often in my day-to-day life.
I'm sure. So, but I'm sure that itna bhi wo jo Padmavat aur Jodha Akbar style hai, itna exemplify karke batate hai, we feel, oh my God, seriously, palace mein aisa hota hoga, I really feel sometimes.
There used to be so much chahal pahal, and there used to be so many functions, so many family members visiting, living, extended family. Your staff used to be so big. They were like, palaces were literally like little villages, na? There was yes. completely self-sustained. Everything was within that campus or your aapke kille jo hote the. So they were very grand. True.
I know. So now, girls, tell me one thing. Tell me one advantage and one disadvantage of being from a royal family. You can only say advantages if you want, but if you can think of a disadvantage, you're more than welcome to say it.
The advantage is that you can ride scooties everywhere.
Yeah, there's a lot of space to do a lot of stuff in the house itself.
Yes, that's your advantage.
You can walk the dogs and it's also nice.
Right. And what do you think? Is there any disadvantage?
Hey,
you can say it. Mommy's not going to say anything. You can directly to people.
What a good point, Lara. You tell.
We're very far from other people. Like, we don't have any neighbors.
That's so true. I am so sure. I know. But I'm sure you guys have the best of both the sides. So, you can't be complaining. So, now, all three of you, we are going to play a nice game. Where you have 2 points. Okay? So, Padmaja and Narayani, you are going to point at each other. Your mother is going to point at whoever it's applicable to. But for you, it's just two of you. Okay, so it's called point at the one game. So, we start, okay? It's going to be a fast one. You have to point. Who is funnier? Radhika, you have to point at any two of the girls that you think. Yeah, okay. Who gets better grades? Better grades.
They have a
okay, confused.
Same.
Who is nicer? Who's nicer? Nicer.
Moms can't answer that question. Yeah, trouble.
Isn't just you can do both of them like that. I mean, I have no issues with that. Who is more responsible?
Responsible?
Who's more responsible? Who, Padmaja, you? Who is lazy?
Oh.
Oh my god. Who is mama's girl? Who is a mama's girl?
Me. I don't know.
Self?
Oh, Padmaja is betting. Who is a foodie? Who is a foodie? Who loves food? Who takes loads and loads of selfies? And who cries in a sad movie, like emotional scenes? Who's the person that cries? That's
the
good.
Laughing all the laughing is Padmaja, all the crying is Narayani.
Oh, is it?
All the comedy is Padmaja. This one doesn't.
It looks very opposite. Okay, it looks very opposite. That Narayani would be the one who would be laughing, and Padmaja would be the one who's more emotional. But yeah, that was a good round, girls. That was a good round. So Radhika, tell me, this is because I've already spoken about you as somebody who's so active in textile, wildlife, being a history graduate. But all this also comes possibly of a doting mother. And in today's world, with the technology abuse, and the societal scanners on you all the time. Plus the responsibility that sets in as a queen, that you have a lot of things to do parallelly. How do you remain grounded mentally is very important in today's, the way we live our lives. Very important how you keep yourself mentally grounded.
I think I just have to make time for things that are important to me. So whether it is that I get that daily time with my kids, if I... I'm traveling, it's fine. I kind of switch off. But when I'm in town and I have, say, things to attend, like you mentioned, the commitments here, my routine is important of where I see my children, I'm with them in the morning, that time, or I put them to bed every evening, we have dinner together. These are things that I have to do every day. It's not like I've set a rule, but I feel my day is incomplete if I've not done that bit, where we've sat and, in bed while I've read the story or before they slept off, that we've had a little chat about the day or things that have happened or what's on our minds. Mm. So you know, these important things keep us both grounded. So, you know, there is this open communication between us where they can tell me, Mama, you didn't do this. And, you know, I said, you know, I didn't want you to tell my secret to so and so. You know, whatever, that free flow of conversation happens.
Yeah, it was space.
Yes. So that is my wonderful grounding time. Speaking to my parents every day. Nowadays, it's all on WhatsApp calls. So that
video
calls. Yeah, that is also, you know, close to home. My time with my husband, every morning we sit together, we get time together, just, you know, while the kids are still asleep. So these, you know, these pockets of space, my time when I do try and put in a time for my meditation. So these, if I stick to those kind of routine, I realize these are the things which keep you grounded and rooted. And I'm biggest critics, you know.
That's true. That's very true. So, but is praying is a kind of, you know, some kind of a spiritual connect for the girls also, a part of a ritual, like a routine for the girl?
Yes. So, not in a religious way. We do try and feel, I mean, we talk about how we feel gratitude for every day. We kind of find something. She's already giving the... It's not something.
I can see. I know.
A lot of gratitude and so much that we feel.
So I'm going to say a quick hi to all the people who have joined in. I read a couple of messages which said, you all four of you look good together. Khamma Kenny for you. And the girls are looking like angels. So thank you everyone for joining in. And
thank you for being here, everyone.
My friend,
their first interview.
I know, first interview. Now it's for the girls. So Narayani and Padmaja, if you woke up one morning, okay, and God is sitting in front of you, and God is saying, "Ja batao, aaj aapko jo banna hai ban lo for one day," who would that person be and why? What would you want to become?
I don't know.
I mean, you can shut your eyes for a minute and think. If I got that chance to become someone tomorrow, who would that be?
A person who has
100
dogs.
A person who has 100 dogs? Seriously?
Yeah, she's very clear. Or a TikTok artist, I think, no?
Ouch. What about you, Padmaja?
The head of the house.
Wow. That is very forward thinking. Oh my god, that's really forward. So now I'm going to play a rapid fire round for your mother, and you both are going to judge her. Okay, you are going to give her out of 10, both of you. So you better listen properly, whether because you know your mother too well, whether she answers all the questions right or not. On that basis, you'll have to give her the. Okay, ready, Radhika, ready?
Yeah, ready.
Okay, so the first one is, what drives you most? Sorry? Okay, I thought there's a question. Okay. So the first question is, what drives you most crazy?
What drives me most crazy? Oh my god, when I see my kids on the iPad.
every mother's same problem, I think. If you were to go for a dinner with any celebrity, who would that be?
Oscar Wilde.
Wow, that's a very good choice. Three words that best describe you. Three words.
Funny, strict, curious mind.
Done. Three done. Funny, strict, and
curious. Strict. I mean, they get to say.
No, they don't, but it's okay. So now I'm going to put in an extra bummer for you. I'm going to count 5 on my fingers. Before that, you have to answer. Or else the girl can put in. Okay. What's your hidden talent?
Writing. Poetry.
So, what's the question that you really detest being asked? Something that you don't like if someone comes and asks you.
How old you are, I guess?
Every woman doesn't like it.
What do you do? Housewife here, people just look down on being a housewife. But then if you look at the size of this house and the come out of work,
nobody can do it. Oh God, that's true. Okay, which is the weirdest rumor that you've heard about yourself?
I haven't actually. Nobody's telling me the rumors about me, unfortunately.
And they're keeping it to themselves. When the time is right, they'll come and tell you. What are the top three on your bucket list?
Top three on my bucket list. I want to do a PhD. I want to write a book. And I want to go to the Arctic.
Sorry, I didn't get the last one. What is the last one?
Arctic.
Oh, you want to go to the Arctic. That's right. Now, this is the last one. And then I'm going to take the marks from Narayani and Padma. If a movie would be made on your life, whom would you see portraying your character? Which actress you think can portray your character the best?
She's saying me. I think she would do a good job. We see a lot of
actors. Narayani likes to act as well.
Yeah. I think maybe Deepika Padukone because she has a nose.
Yeah. And also, I think she can get into that royal character very well, very smooth for her.
That's true.
So, okay, result time, guys. What do you think your mom fared how well out of 10?
Only the last question, I judge it 9.
Only the last question you thought was not right. So you are trying to think you got a 9 on 10?
Yeah, only for the last question.
Where she came in, basically. The question that...
I know. And what about you, Padmaja?
10.
10 on 10. Oh my God. Then she's a completely mama's girl. Completely. Then mama makes mama needs to get everything. That's right. So, Radhika, you know, I believe the fragility of the mental health begins from childhood. Because I am also a mother. And I feel from these are the basic foundation years for our kids. So how are you helping your daughters develop and strengthen their positive growth towards it?
I think first of all, as girls, what becomes an issue is about they should have a positive and healthy body image.
Yes,
so it's
that's
important
very good.
That they embrace the way they are and are comfortable about the way they look and how they carry themselves. And their sense of self is not dependent or drawn from what others think of them. Or what in future, say, boys, or, you know, that eventually is not...
Yeah, body shaming and shaming and all that. Yes, I agree.
On, you know, the sense of self. I think that is the key for any mother, I think, bringing up children. Also, to be able to speak up for themselves. I think we need to teach girls, especially all children, and girls especially, to be able to speak their mind, to be able to know their mind. Very often, I mean, it's not possible to speak because we don't know. So we go with whatever is, you know, expected of us or told to us to do. So it's important to know your mind and only then will you be able to speak it. But speak it coherently, in a respectful way.
Yeah, a proper code of conduct. Yes. But then, to instill these values, are you doing something on a regular basis, like a check? Okay, this is the track that they're following. They can have a mind of their own, obviously, and but are they following the right track? Do you have like your ticks and crosses as to where you keep constant checks on them?
Yes, we do. I think all of us mothers, we have this kind of inbuilt radar. Are they paying too much attention? Are they looking too much in the mirror? Are they getting self-conscious? Are they, what are they seeing on the iPad? My daughters don't have any appliances of their own. They don't have any phone. They have no electronic devices. So they use us. We do you know, we give them for a particular time in a day. So that way, anyway, it is being monitored how much, you know, screen time they're getting and what they are on, what they're actually watching on screen as well. I think that is that has become important now as to what your children are really exposing themselves to. It's not possible to monitor them all the time. But this is something I feel it is, you know, doable if you are able to control what they're watching and for how long they're watching. And of course, just being able to communicate, I feel that it was the same me growing up. My mother was my best friend and so was my sister. So I feel that is, you know, the best I can do for them is be a friend for them.
Yeah, I think that is the missing link. I think that communication is the most important thing that most of the parents in today's age, I think it's a miss, something that is missing there actually, because parents are so busy doing their stuff that they just don't have the time to communicate. It's so important. And yeah, that's a good thing that you guys are communicating on a regular basis. And it's a good thing to do. And I'm going to say hi to everybody who's joining in here. They're saying the girls are looking so pretty, coordinated dresses. Girls, are you happy? Your first interview, so many comments. Not for mom, but for you guys. Oh my God. Okay, so now with the girls, we are going to play a round which is called Copycat. And in that round, what you want to do is, girls, listen. You have to enact a situation. मैं आपको एक situation दूंगी, उसमें से एक बनेगा. There'll be two characters in the situation. One has to pick which is going to be who. Okay? And I want exact replica of that situation, how your mother or your dad would have done it. Not difficult. You do it every day. You see it every day. So the first situation is. Okay, Narayani Padmaja, when your mother is angry, now one become a mother, one becomes a daughter, and show me what happens.
Come on, hurry up.
Come on.
I'm the daughter.
Okay, you're the daughter, okay. Well, from the tone, I would have understood who's a mother and daughter. Angry.
Get lost.
mummy is smiling, nano. Get lost. Itna pyar se. Then, good se. It's okay. We're not comfortable. Relax.
Get lost.
Okay.
I don't want to be your person.
Okay. So, the second situation is your dad is trying to teach you something. Okay. And he's really concentrating hard on both of you guys, like one of you. And you are just distracted. What happens to Papa? What happens to your dad?
He tries to, we run away from him, so he tries to catch us.
No, he's on the table. Maybe he's teaching you a concept of math, okay? And he's telling you, achha, Narayani, aisa hoga, aisa hoga, aisa hoga. And Narayani is somewhere in our own world. And then your dad realizes that Narayani is not paying attention. What happens then? I want to know that.
Okay, he's like, you're not listening to me? No, get ready tomorrow. Tomorrow I'm going to take you out and I'm going to show you what all the poor people go through. Get ready tomorrow at 7 o'clock in the morning.
Oh no, then the whole thing was, we will teach you farming. We are the farming.
Tum ye padhai padhai chodo, I will teach you farming. You do farming only. That's what he'll tell you. Oh my God, so typical with fathers. Okay. Now, Narayani, this one is for you because Padmaja is way too active and she's the one who's participating in everything. So now I want this coming from you. You want to eat out, okay? So how are you going to convince your parents?
Mama, I want to eat out. You never let me order Swiggy and all that.
It's not good for you. You can't do Swiggy. You have to eat what is made at home. Convince your mom.
Then she says, you pay with your own money. She says that.
So, but then do you pay with your money and get the Swiggy or no?
Yeah, sometimes.
And they open more than they are. And they pester and they say, okay, with your own money.
I know. That's good. Actually, that's a very good thing because that's when they start realizing the value of, money. Very important. Very important. Now, this is the last one, okay? before you're going, now I need your first interview, but then too, I want to know this. When you're going for an interview, okay, what are the guidelines your mummy has told you? What were the guidelines she gave you before coming to the interview?
Get ready properly. Oh, just put on some foundation. It makes you look good. You need it. And then it removes the shine. It removes the oiliness of your skin. Wash your face. What is this? Isn't it obvious? You have to wash your face. You guys have no sense of humor.
This is ridiculous.
I wanted it to be a candid talk. Yes, but I did not say don't say this, don't talk about that.
You didn't say.
Yeah, because I said that, you know, let it be an honest term.
Yeah. This is all in the fun spirit, guys, okay? So all the people who have seen that, it's just innocent minds talking. And it's just how such a pure relationship a mother and a daughter has been trying to give you that, guys. Very well done. Narayani, I must say that I'm following off the bench. You got all the marks for that. You did very well. Radhika, you know, I've seen a lot of your interviews where you talk a lot about saris, because I think saris is your passion and love. And even I come from a sari background. And now there is a transformation on, there are a lot of people who are wearing jackets or they're wearing pants or, they're wearing the belts. There's a lot of transformation on how sari is being worn now. So, what's your take on that? Like, how do you see the trend going, or are you okay with the trend, or what are your inputs with those trends?
See, I think the sari is such a versatile fabric. You know, at the end of the day, it's 9 yards of one-stitch gown fabric, textile. So, how you drape it, how you style it is completely individual. And even in our country, there's so many different ways of wearing that same sari. You know, every region, every state, every, you know, village literally has a different way of styling and wearing it. And it's nice that everyone is able to embrace it and make it their own and give it that individual feel. And the idea is that the textile is, you know, made in India, is woven in India, embroidered in India. As long as that is done, you are, you know, that the job is done, because you're able to promote, continue that tradition and make it your own. And you're giving that livelihood and continuing a craft in your country. I think that itself is, and you have to, I think everything needs to be, reinvented to keep it alive. And if the textile, as long as youngsters are embracing it, it's great.
Yeah, I agree. And it's the only one garment where you have this 9 yards of sheer elegance. And which completely changes the way a woman looks, you know. So, sari, because I've also grown up with saris, and I really feel it's the best attire that a woman can adorn.
Mere it just complements every female figure.
So, yeah, that's so true. So, in one of your interviews, I heard, or maybe I think I read, where you said there used to be some Maharani who of Baroda, obviously, precious pearls in and around your garden. So, have you been able to dig them up for us or not yet?
There was a story which they said that Mahani Chimnabai II had buried her pearls in the estate. But my husband is very angry. He says, please don't tell people we go about digging my golf course.
I know, that's so true. So I read it and I was like, let me message and ask whether you really found any pearls or not. Or maybe when people are playing golf and wo divot pada and you pearl nikla, aisa kuch koi instance ho to.
No such luck so far.
I know. So tell me, Padmaja Narayani, I've heard that Padmaja is a very good artist. Is that true?
Yes, I do paint.
Yes, someone told me that she does such immaculate painting, and she has such good flow of art when you paint. So, have you drawn inspiration from your dada Or, you know, you have got, do you, what's going in your mind when you start painting? Like, what do you think? What's your thought process?
I once tried to look at the palace and pick a place to paint from that.
Ah.
I did that.
Okay. And you like
Told
to
myself what my father-in-law's done. He's also done off the courtyards with the arches, and she did something similar. Not really recalling, she's not seen that painting as of now, but she did something similar, which is very nice.
Yeah, that's what I got to know, that she's really good in painting. And what about Narayani? What is your hidden talent? Sorry, I couldn't find anything. I couldn't ask anybody about your hidden talent.
Dance beautifully, you sing beautifully, and she's very good at baking. She's a chef.
Wow. Wow, that's good. So you sing, you dance, and you bake. That's what I heard. Sing, dance, and bake.
Yes, sing, dance, and bake. Padmaja also sings very well.
So, okay, oh my God. Then we have two singers in the house, and I ought to listen something from the girls. Girls, something for the viewers who are listening to you here.
Come on, what
Thoda.
did you say? Both of you? Which is your favorite song at this moment? Any song? Come on, you both sing so well.
Anything,
Okay.
anything. It could be a
Which is
bhajan, it could be a Hindi song, it could be a Marathi
on. Come on.
Waiting. Time is ticking. Okay, I'm not going to put you in a spot if you're not. If you're comfortable, then please go ahead and sing. If you don't want to, then I'm not going to push it.
Okay, she's feeling shy, Padmana. Narayani, you want to give it a go? Okay,
No, it's okay.
sorry.
It's okay. It's okay. Don't push them so much. So, Radhika, tell me one thing. Which is, what is that one thing that what would you say? How to place it? You love being a part of the royalty. Like one thing that makes you feel so good that you're a part of this royalty. I'm sure there are a number of things, but one thing that's close to your heart and you feel, something like that.
I think I, for me, it is I like to be surrounded by the history and the art and architecture. For me, that is a big privilege to be part of the history, to actually
Yeah.
to live in it and also be a narrator of it. To be, it's I think that is the biggest privilege for me.
The biggest thing, I'm sure. So tell me, Padmaja and Narayani, just now you guys had a fashion show, and I think both of you walked the ramp, or only one?
I
You
did.
did. So tell me, so you walked the ramp for the first time, Padmaja?
Yes.
And how was the feeling? Was it nostalgic, or did you get butterflies in your stomach, or you were okay, you were comfortable? What was it?
I was completely fine.
You were completely fine. Wow, that's amazing! Like you had no nervousness, no butterflies in the stomach, nothing.
Nothing.
Seriously? Wow, that's really good. You're really confident then. That's amazing. And Narayani, I always thought Narayani was the talkative of the lot. Now, she's proving me completely wrong, completely wrong. Because whenever Mikhail used to come back, he was like, Narayani talks so much. Padmaja doesn't talk at all. So I think as Narayani is growing older, she's becoming quieter. Is it Narayani? Okay, so tell me, Narayani, what is one thing that you really love about your palace?
Scooty riding.
Sorry?
Because like the hallways are so long, we go in our scooties, so that's fun.
Ah, that's true. And you both have started playing golf now or not yet?
No.
No. So, which is a sport that you like, both of you? Which sport? Sorry?
Basketball.
Basketball. And what about you, Mira?
I was playing football in school.
Wow, that's good. And what about you, Radhika? Have you been able to pursue any sport of late after you left golf or not yet?
No, I played tennis for a bit,
Acha.
but now I'm swimming. But no, I don't. I'm not as sporty as these two. They get it from their father. They both are in the school teams, so
Wow,
they're
that's
doing well for them.
amazing. That's amazing. So tell me, Narayani, Padmaja, you come back home and you realize that the teacher has made a complaint call to your mother. आज तो नारायणी ने बहुत बदमाशी की स्कूल में. पद्मजा रियली यू नो क्रिएटेड अ रकस इन द स्कूल. व्हाट इज द सिचुएशन एट होम आफ्टर दैट कॉल? व्हाट डज मदर डू?
Mama will take away the devices for like a 2 weeks
Yeah,
something.
she would ban our
And
devices give us a
then
holiday.
that's it. Oh, that I was waiting for that. Because that's what Nikhil also says. No more lectures, mommy. Every time you, because it's not a lecture, but as a mother, obviously it's our duty to keep you know telling them what's right or wrong. So yeah. And what does Papa do? That is on mommy's front, but what does Papa do?
He runs behind us and say, "I'll give
Yeah.
you a slap." He
But it
threatened us.
never happens. It never happens. It's
So
like scary
I
over
want to know what drama happens. I want to know what drama happens. Because we feel that only drama happens at our houses, but I didn't know drama happens at your house also.
He would just say, "I wanted to do better next time." There's like not much of punishment or anything.
But I think not many parents now punish their children because now you're all grown up and you all know what you need to do. And maybe after giving the right direction, you guys will be back on track. I hope all mothers think too. So yeah, that's good. So if you have any questions for me, you can shoot some questions for me also, Narayani and Padmaja. Otherwise, I'll keep asking.
Hi, can you say something here? Yeah, she had a question. What did you do for the talent round?
For Mrs. India.
Since you became Mrs. India?
हाँ, I'll tell you. So, you know, I'll tell you, Mrs. India, that my pageant supports breast cancer. So we had only 1.5 minutes. So I did a contemporary dance only on breast cancer. So I had a placard, and then I was jumping here and there. But it was not a typical Bollywood dancing, more like ballet. So I did a little bit of ballet. Then, you know, I sat down and then I showed the placard and all that. But I am sure I did not win the talent round because the other 99 contestants were way, way more talented than I was. But it's not only about the talent, it's about a lot of other factors that go in, like how you conduct yourself, how well you present your, you know, when you're coming down with your makeup. So there are a lot of other things also that go into it. But I don't think I won on the basis of talent. Other people were way better. And Padmaja, do you have a question for me?
No.
No. Okay. So tell me, Radhika, it has been so many years in Baroda now. Okay. And like it's been 16 years, like how you and I, we both have spent enough years in Baroda. But do you yet miss your maternal home or do you yet miss certain things that you used to do there and that you can't do here?
Not really. I think in the beginning, yes, when we were newly married, I think we missed all the
I know.
baristas and the multiplex and the
Tell me about it. I know.
and other than, you know, being with your parents every day and you know, that was probably the, you know, the comfort level of being in your own house. When you're
Huh.
newly married, you will not take that second or third helping even if you like the dish. So you know, that kind of you know, अपने घर में you wouldn't do that.
Yeah.
But now that is not the case anymore. Now it
Yeah.
is more like, okay, once you go home, I'm in my nightie or the night suit the whole day, you know. किसी से
हाँ,
मिलना नहीं है, कहीं जाना नहीं है. You're just vegetating at home. I think
हाँ
that's what I look forward to it, going, because everything is available everywhere. It's not really about going shopping. You meet your friends, you meet your family, and then it's just about really relaxing and just feeling that you're
just being your own skin. So, you know, that's what you can do when you're at your mom's. Just let it be, just be the way you are. I know, I completely agree. So now we're going to come to the end, almost end of the session. And last question for the girls. Tell me, Narayani and Padmaja, first tell me, have you guys ever been for a night out with your friends at your friend's house?
Yeah, many times.
Many times?
Yes.
So tell me, little question, but I'm going to ask. When you are at night out, what do you guys normally do? Because my son keeps asking me, if I go for a night out, what am I supposed to do at night? So now I'm going to take tips from you. What do you guys do at night outs when you go to your friends?
We usually talk about school, all the gossip and things like that.
Oh, whole night gossiping.
Yeah, there is like always that much stuff to talk about. We switch schools, so like when we've been going to our old school friends' homes, then we have a lot to discuss about our schools. And then we watch a movie. Sometimes we dance and, you know, judge each other.
That's good. So now, since you guys didn't sing for me, I think you should dance a little bit for me. Maybe they will never come on in the interview again with Pooja Aunty on the dance and sing and all that. But no, I'm not going to make you dance. But thank you so much, guys, for being here today evening. And it was so much fun. I really enjoyed the session with the girls more than Radhika. It's their first time. And keep shining always, girls. And keep bumping into us wherever we are on the golf course. But thank you so much, Radhika. It was indeed a true, true pleasure to have you and your family here.
Wonderful set of questions. Very well balanced.
But next time I'm going to push Sam to be there as well, like a family thing. But thank you. And bless you all. See you.
Bye.
Bye. See you. So, guys, that was Her Highness Maharani Radhika Raje for you guys. And how she is as a person, related to her saris and jewelry and a lot of other stuff has been spoken about. But I wanted to get this aspect of hers to you. And I'm sure they enjoyed, and I enjoyed too. Our next session is going to be day after at 7. Sorry, not 7. Sorry. Just mark that. It's at 5 p.m. with Siddharth Randeria. And he is from Gujjubai Rocks. Everybody knows him. And you got to be there because it is going to be a session filled with laughter, fun, games, talk, and never-ending conversations. So I'll see you day after at 5 p.m. on Off the Record with Pooja. Thank you.